I'm Earl Stewart. I welcome you to Earl Stewart on Cars Mystery Shopping Report. This is the mystery shop of AutoNation, Chevrolet, and Greenacres. This week, CBS News featured a story on the Takata airbag recall crisis. The piece focused on a report by the United States Public Research Group that concluded that 1 in 9 used cars being offered for sale by AutoNation has a safety recall issue. 1 in 9. Now, this is staggering. When you buy a used vehicle from AutoNation, you're playing Russian roulette. You have 1 chance out of 9 of having bought a car that can kill you. And the fact that this is going on says something about our legislature, our politics, our regulators. It says something about the American system, where money can trump life. Anyway, the PIRG, which is the U.S. Public Research Group, they looked at 2,400 used vehicles at 28 AutoNation locations and found 267 vehicles that pose serious safety threats to their occupants. That's astonishing. A lot of the bad things that happen with car dealers are based on carelessness and stupidity. And sometimes the guy in the ivory tower, the dealer or the CEO of AutoNation, he thinks things are going okay, but in the trenches, they're not going okay. And we're in the trenches and we're shopping these people, and the AutoNation stores are selling these dangerous cars, and it's happening, and we can prove it, and we have a copy of the mystery shopping report in Anna Werner's hands right now. We've conducted several Takata mystery shops at AutoNation stores over the last 3 years. Only one effectively disclosed a recall. Only 1 in 3 years. We selected one of these stores to see if this was the case: AutoNation, Chevy, and Greenacres. It was easy to find cars with Takata recalls in AutoNation Chevy's online used car inventory. We found 3 in a few minutes. We chose to shop and buy a 2014 Mercedes 250 with a no-fix Takata airbag recall. That means that this car, if they did know and disclose that it had a airbag recall, there's nothing they could do about it. Nope. Disclosure means nothing when you say you can't fix the car. And we sent in a female mystery shopper, agent 26, in response to a lot of people that have been asking us to use more female shoppers. Here's a report speaking as if I were the shopper. I called the dealership prior to departing on my mission to find out if they still had the 2014 Mercedes C250. I spoke to a gentleman named Joe, who put me on hold to check the key machine. He returned to the call, informing that it was there and ready for sale. I told Joe there I'd be in 45 minutes. I arrived at 11:30 a.m. and went inside the building. I asked the receptionist if she could help me locate Joe. She tried for several minutes to reach him by phone, but gave up. She directed me towards the used car building, where she said I could find him. I went back outside, got my car, and drove to the used car area. I was greeted by a salesperson. I told him, "I'm looking for Joe." The salesperson walked me inside and introduced me to Joe. Joe was ready with the keys and a dealer plate, took me back outside, walked me to the car. He asked me if I wanted to drive it. I said I did. He didn't ask for my license. There's a little more incompetence there. All car dealers require, their insurance companies require them, and they require the salespeople to get a copy of the driver's license before they let them take a test drive. So policies are not enforced, folks, and that is the true danger. I know no one in AutoNation headquarters, board of directors, wants anybody to be hurt by a car you sell. But the policies are not being carried out, and what you're about to hear happens in a lot of your car dealerships. So, on the test drive, Joe said it was a nice car and said it had never been in an accident. You'll find out later, that's some more incompetence, according to Carfax. He was really nice and made a pleasant conversation. I learned a lot about his career in the car business. He'd been doing this a long time. I asked Joe if there was any mechanical issues to talk about. Joe simply replied that AutoNation does a 125-point inspection on all their used cars. We went back to small talk. As we approached the dealership, I asked Joe if there were any safety issues with the vehicle that he was aware of. Now, he did say this. He believed there was an open passenger side airbag recall. Credit Joe, okay? That's one for Joe. When we parked, Joe took a Carfax report and a service history report. We walked back to his office where he reviewed the Carfax report with me. He said he had to correct an earlier statement he made. Joe said he mistakenly told me there had been no accidents. And he pointed out accidents on the Carfax report. He did emphasize that the report indicated only minor damage. He told me that if any issue, like severe damage, odometer problems, or lemon laws appear on the report within a year of my purchase, AutoNation would buy the car back. That's a nice touch.
Yeah.
That's a really good marketing thing to do because people aren't going to be aware of it anyway. He never made mention of the recall again. I waited to see if he would advise me. And remember, this recall is unfixable. Yeah. There's no part available. Never mention it again. I waited to see if he would advise me on of how or when I could have the defect remedied, but he never did. I told him I loved the car, I was ready to make a deal. He said he'd get the manager to write it up for me. Joe returned with a buyer's order, and he reviewed it with me. The top line was Kelley Blue Book retail value, $12,121. Next, they showed $1,523 in AutoNation savings, which made my selling price $10,598. And that was the same price I saw on mine.
Yep.
That's a good thing. That used to be the case. We're seeing in more and more car dealerships, the online price equals the price that, you know, they sell the car, or they say they sell the car for. Then they added, here we go, $799 dealer fee. Hidden fee, you don't know about it until you come in to buy the car. And pretty hefty, $549 tag and registration. We say hefty because it's suspiciously high, that it might not really be that much. My total was $12,695, and I said I thought it was a fair deal. Joe said I could get into finance right away, but I said I need to take the buyer's order home with me to go over with my mom. I explained that she was advising me on my first car purchase, and this is a young female car shopper.
26.
I asked if he could hold the car for one day. Joe said he'd have to ask his manager. Joe returned, said that unfortunately, I'd have to leave a deposit for them to hold the car. I said I couldn't do that. My mom had specifically warned me against that.
Yeah.
Good advice. I said I would take my chances and would call the next day to see if it had been sold. I took my copies of the Carfax report, the buyer's order, the service history, and some warning info with me. Although Joe did acknowledge that they got a recall, it fell far short of an effective disclosure. It was a far cry from what AutoNation describes as AutoNation's robust policies and procedures. AutoNation states that all customers are required to sign a recall disclosure acknowledgement prior to the sale. This didn't happen today. Maybe that form would have come later in F&I. We don't know. Probably would have come later in F&I. And all the car dealers are putting the hairy stuff, the stuff they don't want you to see, into the F&I.
The non-sexy stuff.
Yeah. You buy the car when you shake the salesman's hand and you say, we have a deal.
Yep.
You buy the car, you're emotionally, mentally,
you own
in
it.
Every other way, you bought the car. The rest of it is annoying, detailed paperwork.
Right.
You don't pay attention. Your attention dissipates, your euphoric nature. You probably get a picture taken with a car, picture with a salesman and the car, you're smiling, and then you go into the box, which is the F&I department, and that's where you sign all these papers, and you don't know what you're signing.
Yeah.
And that's the sad, sad truth. So this disclosure is a joke. The car dealers are saying they disclose this. AutoNation said they disclose this. They're not doing it, folks. They're not doing it. This is proof right here. This mystery shopping report is proof that AutoNation and the other car dealers are not disclosing what they did. If they did disclose it, it's still immoral to sell a car with a dangerous Takata airbag recall that can't be fixed. Disclosure is a joke. It's not happening. What is happening is people are buying the cars and they're driving them home with their families, and just not right. We're going to fail Chevrolet and Greenacres, but I'm going to fail on the basis of the fact that they knew there was a recall and they knew it couldn't be fixed and they were willing to sell the car. I think that's got to be a failing offense, and I know it's going to be hard to have recommendations out there. Hi, this is Earl Stewart. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to be notified of new videos that we post to our YouTube channel, simply click on the subscribe button at the lower right-hand side of the screen. Earl Stewart.